Hey guys, this is AI Gaming 1776, and we are looking at Far Cry 4 with a GTX 960 4GB card by EVGA, the For the Win edition. In the upper right-hand corner, you can see that we are at 64 degrees, operating speed is 1405, VRAM usage is 2.3 gigabytes, frame rate is at 144 because we're using a 144Hz monitor, and system RAM is at 5.2 gigabytes. We are at full 920 by 1080p, we're at full screen, again 144, and let's look at the graphics settings. We have textures on ultra, shadows on high, post effects on ultra, geometry on very high, vegetation on medium, terrain on ultra, water on low, environment on high, ambient occlusion on SSAO, anti-aliasing is off, god rays are off, fur is simulated, and tree relief is off. Now, as you can see, game looks pretty good considering that a lot of those settings were on medium or low or high as opposed to everything being on ultra. Game looks pretty good indeed. So it is nighttime. We are going to hop in our little flying grasshopper thing, whatever it's called. We're going to hop into that and we're going to fly over to the brick factory. This is, what is this thing called? Does it tell me? I used to know what this thing was called, dang it. It's got a name. Anyway, we're going to fly this over to the brick making factory. Now, the graphics I chose basically are graphics that will keep this card for sure above 60 frames per second, but also have things looking really good. We have textures on ultra, we have terrain on ultra, we do have ambient occlusion turned on. I have anti-aliasing off, and I'm going to be honest with you. I normally like anti-aliasing in just about every game I can think of. I can think of very few games. Right now, I can't think of any where I don't like it on. Even The Witcher 3, I like anti-aliasing on in that game. The problem is anti-aliasing hits this game pretty hard, and a lot of people would make the argument that Far Cry 4 is not a very good PC port, this, that, or the other. I don't know. I mean, I think it's beautiful on PC. We can argue about how well it's optimized. We can argue about a whole lot of things. But the game is friggin' beautiful on PC. Okay? Whether it should be getting a higher frame rate or it should be doing this or that, that's a whole nother conversation. So, these are the settings I showed you. These are the settings I use. Look, we're at 85 frames per second. Now it's fluctuating, which just went up to 90, 92 frames per second. And then when we land here, probably going to be around 68, maybe. We'll see. The game does not perform consistently. Oh, look, 59 frames per second. Oh, that's not great. It's not brilliant. 57. It's still in the 60 neighborhood. And again, that's why I chose these settings. This is actually my second time making this video. And when I made this video a half an hour ago, I was above 70 frames per second right here. Far Cry 4 has always done this to me, and I don't know why. I don't know why it's inconsistent. Look, obviously, like in a lot of games, when you look straight up at the sky, look, 87 frames per second. That's like a little trick right there. 90 frames per second just looking up. And then you look down, oh, look, this is where it should be. It's 79. 72 even. Now we're at 67. I was expecting to be in the mid-60s on this pile of bricks. Somewhere in there, maybe even the 70s. And now we're here. Why was it in the 50s just a minute and a half ago? I don't know. Why is it in the 60s right now? I don't know. The game does perform inconsistently for me, which is why I choose the settings that I choose. Okay? I choose the settings that I choose because worst case scenario, it might be like 57 frames per second, but when it wants to act right, you know, it'll get between 60 and 90. So this is an area that I like to go to. Here, I'm looking through the camcorder viewfinder right now. This is an area that I like to go to test out new graphics cards in this game. I go to the brick factory because there's a ton of lines everywhere. As a matter of fact, when you're trying out various forms of anti-aliasing, I will tell you, if you have a GTX 970 on a good day or a GTX 980 on pretty much any day, if you put it on MSAA times 4, this area looks very beautiful because there's all these lines everywhere. which obviously is going to benefit from anti-aliasing. See, I mean, it's just lines upon lines upon lines. You got all these bricks drawn. There's bricks on the ground. There's bricks and little building situations all over the place over here. But you also get to take a look at how the trees look, how the mountains look in the skyline. I also use this to adjust my color settings, brightness, contrast, and gamma. Because if you have it too dark, it's not as vibrant. It's not as pleasing to the eye. But if you make it too bright, what happens is those mountains, those white mountains, will actually blend into the sky. So for me, this is my spot where I go when I want to test out settings or a graphics card. Why don't you guys let me know your spot? I would be interested to see how cool your spot is. Now, one of the good things about this spot is you see, let's go look at the map. I flew to it from, okay, you start the game here in the Banipur village, and then this is the first outpost that you unlock, and then they have the little helicopter thing, and then the brick factory is like right there. So even if this game is new to you, you can get to this place pretty quickly. Now, if you notice, the game was dark when we set out. It was about 6 a.m. in game time. And the reason why I do that, actually, here, we're about to fly again, or actually maybe we'll fast travel. The reason why I do that is I've noticed that this area where I'm at here, this is a really good spot to catch at sunrise. And if you run around here, oh, pro tip here. In this game, if you want time to advance, you have to move, even if you aim your weapon. All right, see how there's a watch, how he's got a watch on his left hand? So as you aim your weapon around, see there, the time just ticked. It went click. It clicked a few minutes. If you stand here for an hour, time is not going to change. But as you move, you will notice the minute hand moving on that watch. All right, so that's a pro tip in case you wanted to know how the day-night cycle works in this particular game. Because most games, the day-night cycle is going to change even if you don't move. So 62 frames per second, that's not fantastic, I admit. But it is what it is. So the game is really crisp, it looks really good. Even without AA, it looks really good. The textures are really rich, everything's really, really nice. These are good settings. You can actually crank the settings up if you want to, but your frame rate's going to tank. All right? Because what this game does is it loads at certain points. So typically these settings, this graphics card, what will happen is I will get in the 70s, right? From 68 to 80 frames per second, somewhere in there in the neighborhood of 70 frames per second. For whatever reason, the card is, or the game or whatever, is performing not as well as normal. And look, now we're up to 69, 70. See, this is the neighborhood it normally stays in, from 68 to 80. Why it's fluctuating right now, I have no idea. All right. But because it does fluctuate, I choose settings that will allow for that. So even when this game is trying to give me a hard time, even when it's loading, even when there's a big firefight, I'm only going to go down to the mid-50s. Now, you might have noticed, like I said, I'm using a high refresh rate monitor with the GTX 960. And a lot of you might think that is crazy. Like, why would I do that? I know that, look, we're at 77 frames per second. I know that on the internet, the common wisdom or logic or whatever is, actually, you know, there's a cool bell tower over here, I think. I think it's this one. Let's go over here. It's kind of pretty over here. We can aim at it. There we go. All right. So the wisdom on the internet is, oh, well, if you're going to go high refresh rate, you better bring a lot of firepower. You better have a really strong graphics card. And that's true if you want to hit 144 frames per second, which this monitor is capable of. Oh, and in case you're wondering, the difference between 120 and 144, if you're wondering, is it noticeable? Actually, yes, it is noticeable. I wasn't prepared for that, but it is. And remember, this is, you know what, let's go for this outpost. I'm not going to try to take it. I'm just going to try to cause havoc and see what that does to the frame rate. So anyway, yes, there is a difference between 120 and 144. And yes, I am using a GTX 960, with a 144 hertz monitor. Now, this is not my normal card. However, I am doing a GTX 960 review. I have four 960s. They're all very different. Matter of fact, the number one reason why I'm making this video is when I do the review, I'm going to link to this video and one for Grand Theft Auto, one for Assassin's Creed Unity, and so on for all these different games. I'm making all these different videos because I am showing you guys live benchmarks. The proof is in the pudding. This is how the card performs. If I say this is how it performs, then this is how it performs. I'm not just going to hit you with a... you know, like a little PowerPoint slide with a graph on it. I'm not going to do that to you. I'm giving you real demonstrations of how the card performs. Now, I'm using a camcorder because all of my game capture options stop at 60 frames per second. Whether I use Shadowplay or I use my Elgato, they can all do 1080p 60 frames per second. And maybe Shadowplay can do higher resolution, but on mine, I think it says it only goes up to 60 frames per second because I've tried with other graphics cards to get that sucker up to like at least 120 and it didn't happen. So I'm using a camcorder because I don't want to it's a long story. I'm using a camcorder because this is the easiest way to get the game to play authentically at its real frame rate, resolution, and all that. Because if I go through... Okay, so if I run Shadowplay, please forgive me for going inside baseball here, but I'm just going to tell you, because I know some people are going to be like, well, why didn't you do this or that? So if... And we're at 68 frames per second while we're just chilling here. So if I'd use Shadowplay, even with a GTX 970, and even though everyone says, oh, Shadowplay is not very demanding, it still affects the performance of the game. I've tested this already. So while I play the game, it stutters, it feels sluggish. So you're not seeing the real performance the card can do because my system is simultaneously trying to capture gameplay. And even Shadowplay, still you're not seeing the full capability of the card. Okay, cool. So most of my videos, I've used an Elgato game capture device with a second computer. All right, well, why am I not doing that now? Well, the reason is when I used a 60 hertz monitor, that was fine. The Elgato only captures at 60 hertz. The monitor was 60 hertz. Everything was cool in the game. Now, I go to a 144 hertz monitor like this one. It's not cool in the game anymore because what happens is when I use HDMI and when I use the Elgato, VSync is going to cap the game at... Whoa, they see me. VSync is going to cap the game at 60 frames per second. So you're not going to see when it goes up to 70. You're not going to see when it goes up to 80 frames per second. You're not going to see that. Okay. Why don't I just turn off VSync? All right, well, fine. I can do that. But then you're going to see screen tearing. So you're still not going to really see what the game looks like. So at the end of the day, I, at this moment, do not have any ability to properly record higher than 60 frames per second gameplay. That's where we're at. And the thing that I want to show you guys on the internet and around the world is even a lower powered card, the GTX 960 is a lower mid-grade card. It's a mid-grade card. It's like lower middle class, right? It's a $200 card. This right here is a $255 card. Okay, it's a for the win card. It's $255. So that's not cheap, especially when you can get a 970 for $310. Or an AMD or whatever for other prices. But I want to show you guys, like, no BS, okay, no BS. Far Cry 4 with good settings, textures on ultra, terrain on ultra, ambient occlusion on, the picture looks good, okay? I'm picky. That's why I've spent so much money to do PC gaming, because I'm picky. So if I tell you that this looks good, I'm not BSing you. This looks really good. I know I'm using a camcorder, it doesn't do it justice, but I want to show you guys that even with the GTX 960, if you have a high refresh rate monitor, this is a 1080p high refresh rate monitor, but if you have one, even a GTX 960 is going to get you anywhere. You've already seen from the the mid-50s all the way to the 70s or 80s. Now, the 70s, 80s, well, the 80s and 90s were kind of cheating because I was flying or, like, looking at the skybox. See, there we go, 90 frames per second when you look straight up. And then you look down here and it goes down to 66. But this is good. This is good. One more thing before I go into this compound. One more thing, and thank you for listening to me and thank you for indulging me. I got this game in January and it performed better in January than it does now. When they updated this game to receive its DLC, the Season Pass DLC, the Rise of the Yeti and all that stuff, and there was the escape from the prison or whatever, when they did that, they broke the performance of the game, which is really annoying because I got this game in January, I got my computer in January, and soft shadows worked at that point with the GTX 970, and it kept a solid 60 frames per second. Now, I only had a 60 hertz monitor, but it kept a solid 60 frames per second. Oh, man, this looks really good. It doesn't look as good on the camcorder, but you can see, like, it contrasts, it pops. Picture's not too bright, not too dark. Here, I'll get over here so you can see. Like, you can see the mount, like, there's the white mountain, the brown mountain, the trees, a very... Like, I promise you guys, this looks really good at 68 frames per second. All right, so what happened was the game was getting a solid 60 frames per second with soft shadows on with my GTX 970. And ever since then, I've never been able to use soft shadows again. Soft shadows, like, do not keep 60 frames per second, and it's annoying. Do you guys care to know that? I don't know. I'm just letting you know it is a PC port, and this is what I've noticed. However, this still looks good. This still destroys the console. I have a PS4. I actually have this game on the Xbox One, and I know it's not full 1080p on the Xbox One. But no, this is good. So what we're going to do... Oh, he sees me. And he's shooting me. All right, so what we're going to do... Really? When it rains, it pours... Getting bit by an animal, getting shot by people. 66 frames per second. You guys are going to have to look at that frame rate counter because I'm going to be looking at this action. Wait a minute. Where'd this compound go? Oh, I'm going to have to put it on my map. How stupid is that? Seriously. Oh, there it is. Outpost, compound, whatever. All right. Where you at, buddy? Okay, are you... Did I select... Oh, yeah, I guess I did. There it is. All right, so let's go in here. You know what's an awesome gun? The Shredder. This gun is so overpowered. It's an SMG that can... It's a silenced SMG that can take out a bear. Bye-bye. And bye-bye. Oh, we're in the 70s for the frame rate. Everything's pretty and shiny. You know what? Let's throw some meat. There we go, some bait. Oh, reinforcements are coming. 70 frames per second. And then look how pretty these flowers are. Look, I'm going to give you a tour of the flowers while I'm getting shot at. Hey. Yeah, no, this gun is OP, bro. I'm actually not going to use it. Ooh, let's use the grenade thing here. The one-handed grenade launcher. But remember, I'm just screwing around. We're at 60 frames per second. But still... Now, why it's doing this, I don't know. It was at, 55, 58, 52 even frames per second earlier when I wasn't fighting, and then it's at 60 now. Why does the game perform inconsistently? I don't know. Well, fudge. Ooh, that was a bad idea. www.badidea.com. Yeah. Just blew myself up with C4. I didn't see what the frame rate was for all that. All right, where is this outpost? Actually, let's not do the outpost. Let's do... It's a buzzer. That's what that flying thing is called. I need a vehicle. So let's go get this vehicle. Because I'm pretty sure my buzzer is gone. I didn't see it on the map. Yeah, we're at 60 frames per second now, and we're just running. Now we're at 66. Now, why is it lower when you're not even in a fight? I don't know. And then it went up to 90 when I slid down the hill. This game's going to be all over the place. Like, we just have to live with that. That's the reality that we live with. That's the world that we live in. the game does not perform consistently. This is where I wanted to go anyway. Oh boy, I forgot how to drive. Hey, aim. Or drive, actually. Oh, cool, it's on automatic. I'm not going to do automatic, though. All right, so here we go, we're driving. 72, 73 frames per second. What I'll do is I'm going to go to this bell tower, and then I'll up the settings when I get there. Now, it is possible that the game will make me look like a liar. That happens sometimes. It's possible that I'm going to put this stuff up higher, and the graphic, not the graphics, but the frame rate's not going to get any worse. But again, I was telling you, I choose the settings I choose to make sure I consistently get above 60 frames per second, even if that means there were some spots that were in the 50s for whatever reason. Why? I don't know. Why was it in the 50s? I don't know, because the game's inconsistent. And now we have a black screen. No, I don't want to keep that, whatever I just did. What did I just do? Don't know. Okay then. Actually, let's do the ultra preset. Let's make things simple. Ultra preset is on, and for whatever reason, it made the gamma look off. Okay, is the ultra preset really on? Yeah. Graphics on ultra, okay? Still looks sharp. It's still, we're at 50 frames per second, because again, the game gets kind of funky. Look, we're at 42 frames per second. Now, it was at 60 when I first took it out of that options menu. Now we're at 43. And this is what I was talking about. The settings that I chose looked good. They weren't, the game wasn't maxed out, but it looked good, and I'm picky, so if I say it looked good, then it did look good. But it kept us like at least in the 50s. At its worst, and it was playing, not just looking at the skybox, but playing in the 70s and 80s. Went up to 90 a couple times. And remember, this is a 960. Oh, by the way, 70 degrees, 1405 for the operating speed, 2.58 gigabytes of VRAM, so that's almost 2.6 gigabytes of VRAM, and we're using 5.8 gigabytes of system RAM right now. Games on Ultra. I think the settings I chose look better, and that is a common theme. When you watch my videos, I will often tell you that I think the settings that I choose look better than Ultra. Because I think there's an art to stressing your graphics card. Okay, let's stand still. 47, it was a 50. Just because we can be in the 40s on Ultra does not mean that Ultra is where you want it to be. A lot of people get that confused. They say, oh, well, it's on the Ultra preset, and it's in the 40s for the frame rate, so this is awesome. No, it's not awesome. The Witcher 3 is one of the few games that looks truly beautiful even when it's in the 40s for the frame rate, okay? That's The Witcher 3. A lot of games need to be in the 50s. They just do. And I mean, like, steady in the 50s, right? We're at 49. We were lower than that. I think it might have... Oh, look, some dude materialized. Now, that happens no matter what in this game. The game just does that. Let's see if we can travel somewhere real quick, like fast travel. Let me go towards this bell tower. I'm not going to promise... Wait a minute, do I have that bell tower or not? Now I got to look. And let me get a drink of water. I will say turning up the graphics does make NPCs look even better. Like, she looks pretty good. I'm assuming that Ultra turned up the geometry. So let's go into the quality. Right. So what I do with my GTX 970 is instead of using anti-aliasing, I turn up geometry because this is a game that really benefits from it. All right, we're still on the Ultra preset. And yeah, there's a bell tower that we don't have. So pick that. And is there a car? Or am I going to have to hoof it? I guess I got to walk. And which direction is it? This way. All right. We'll see how far we get. I may or may not take this bell tower. I may feel like I've said enough and turn the game off. Turn the video off. All right, so we're at 40 frames per second. See, it just went down to 40. There's a firefight over here. Just like a little skirmish. Now, can I climb? Oh, look, there's a bear. Check this out. The shredder is so overpowered. Hi, this is my submachine gun that murders a bear. Look how fast that was. I forget how you unlock the shredder. It'll tell you if you don't have it unlocked, you know, all the signature weapons, it tells you how to unlock them. So I forget what I did to get it, but yeah, the shredder is super overpowered. It's awesome. The shredder and the predator. I don't think the predator is overpowered. The fire rate on it's kind of slow. Plus, it does actually, if you don't do headshots, it actually does have trouble killing people. So the predator sniper rifle, that is not overpowered. Now, I think the game is a little more foggy right now. Oh, I forgot. The game saves every time you talk to a Sherpa. So we're stuck with all the BSing around that I've done. Like, we're stuck with that. Alright, so let's see if we can take this bell tower. I'm not good at these, so I may or may not follow through with this. I may just decide it's not worth it. Oh, look at this. Gonna murder ya. 187. Come on. There we go. I never said that I am super good at the shooter skills. I never made that claim. 54 frames per second. Oh, this guy is... If you keep headshotting these guys, it stun locks them. But you can also have to reload, and then there you go. See, the shredder's pretty tough. Pretty tough weapon. All right, where are we going? Can we even do this? I don't know. No. All right, grapple. Okay, so. Oh, look, we're at 60 some odd frames per second when I point it straight up. I'm probably not going to do this tower and talk to you guys at the same time. I don't know if I'm talented enough to do that. Because I don't really know where I'm going. You want to know how I normally get these bell towers? I use the buzzer. You can fly to the top of these bell towers, land on top, and take them with the buzzer. I kid you not, you don't have to go through the little platforming business. Alright, can I make that jump? Or is this like a fool's errand right here? No, we can make it. First person platforming, not too bad in this game. Gotta admit, it is not too shabby. I think we're just about to the top of this. Why I cannot, maybe I got a duck? There we go. Yeah, we're almost up here. I'm surprised I still have any of these left. All right. Whoa, you can fall off there very quickly if you don't take it slowly. Oh yeah, I think volumetric fog and stuff does not look so good in this game. I think that since I've turned it on to Ultra, the game looks kind of hazy and not so attractive. That's, again, it's all subjective. I mean, it's my opinion. I think the settings I chose earlier are probably the strongest settings, because there is a return on investment for having a higher frame rate. A lot of people might not realize that. Sometimes you're better off with lower settings and a higher frame rate than you are at lower frame rate and higher settings. So, I love this game. I love how you, like, some dudes are just driving by and you grenade them. Like, it's almost like trolling. And I don't feel bad because it's a video game. They're not real people. So you can troll them. It's not terrible to troll a video game, I don't suppose. Anyway, let's go ahead and take this tower and wrap this video up. Point being, GTX 960, even with a game like Far Cry 4, there are some benefits for using a high refresh rate monitor. We're using 2.5 gigabytes of VRAM right now. We're using 2.4 gigabytes of VRAM. We had it on the Ultra preset, and it played anywhere from the low 40s to the mid to high 50s. I personally wouldn't recommend that. I would say use the settings I had. Even with the water on low, you're not in water that often, so like, the underwater not looking so great, that doesn't really affect you because you're not in the water very often. And if you want, you can turn the water up like when you're there. But from what I understand, and I even went to GeForce's website, GeForce.com, and I'm pretty sure that I read that the water setting on here mostly affects how reflective the water is. And I don't care about that. So you guys saw how I had the settings earlier. Water was on low. Shadows were still on high. Textures were on ultra and so on. You can go back to the start of the video and see all that. But this should give you an idea of how well the game performs with the 960. And honestly, it's not bad. I mean, people like to give this game crap, and yeah, if you have it on the ultra setting, and if you turn on anti-aliasing at MSAA times 4 or TXAA or whatever, then yeah, it's going to play like crap. But if you use the settings that I used at the start of the video, you're going to see anywhere from the high 50s to about 80 frames per second continuous gameplay. Like legit gameplay. And that's part of why I make these videos. I make these videos to show you guys, because I hate to say it, but the common knowledge on the internet, I'm a new PC gamer. I've only been PC gaming for 8 months. So I'm not that new. I'm not brand new. And I've spent thousands of dollars on hardware and games now. My Steam library is well over 100 games. I'm not bragging or anything. I mean, there's Steam sales and you can get games for like $2. So I'm not bragging. But the point is, like, I've invested time and money into this over the 8 months. So I'm new-ish, you know, I'm not old school, but I do know a lot, you know, like I've learned quickly. Anyway, point being, when I was brand new, when I was completely new back in January and I was looking on the internet for advice, I feel like a lot of that advice failed me. I feel like I've had to learn the hard way that the so-called common knowledge or the so-called common wisdom doesn't really hold up. All right, because what happens is people want there to be absolutes. People want there to be, oh, well, if you're gaming at whatever, blah, 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 like it's an algebra equation where you like fix X and Y and all that, X and Y equals Z, where it's like, oh, well, if you're gaming at 1080p, you only need this. Or if you're gaming at 24 inches, you only need this. Or if you're using AMD, here's the thing, guys, there's too many variables. Okay, like even random things like the power supply that you're using can affect your graphics, okay? It can make your card have coil whine, it can affect your frame rate, your motherboard. Certain motherboards have compatibility issues with certain processors or graphics cards or RAM, and there's like weird compatibility things that people might not see. Because like what happens is when you build your own computer, which I did not, but when you build your own computer, you can mix and match from a lot of different brands, a lot of different things. If I've got a 4790 processor, and if I want, I can use a cheap motherboard that's like $80. I can use like a $400 motherboard. There are so many variables, and we're not all going to have the same experience. And a lot of people try to act like one size fits all, and it does not. So I make these videos so I can show you. Like, if this was a typical benchmarking video, what would it show you? It would say, well, it went as high as 90 frames per second. It went as low as, you know, 42 frames per second. So what's the average? And then you guys would just see, like, oh, well, here's the average, and here's the min, and here's the max. And I think that information is very helpful. But I also think it does not tell you the whole story. Because it's possible, if I just showed you a chart with the minimum, the maximum, and the average frames this game got with this card, I don't think it would have painted the picture for you as well as this video did. I showed you, okay, well, this is where it gets such and such frame rate, and this is where it gets that frame rate. And by the way, the game can be inconsistent. For some reason, it'll go down to the 50s, and then it'll bounce back up into the 60s or the 70s. And I make all that clear, and I share all that info. And this is info that has taken me dozens of hours per game and thousands of dollars out of my pocket for me to figure this out. I don't get things sent to me in the mail, all right? Companies do not send me graphics cards or computers or game codes or whatever. So I have to buy these games. I have to buy benchmarking software. I use 3D Mark software for some of my benchmarking. I have four different GTX 960s that I'm looking at for review right now because when I review the 960, I'm not just going to do benchmarks on like four or five games over the course of one day and then spit out a video for you. I'm going hardcore with this review, all right? I am giving you live benchmarking videos for multiple games, showing you with your own eyes exactly how the game performed, and I'm telling you, because sometimes in an internet video, it's not always obvious. So I'm telling you, like, hey, right now it's stuttering, or right now it's going down in quality. Or like I told you right now, the Ultra, we're on Ultra getting 54 frames per second. That sounds respectable, right? I don't think it looks as crisp as it did earlier because it's a lower frame rate. And because the volumetric fog in this game, I think, kind of dilutes the image. So I'm making all of this stuff clear to you guys. I'm not just, honestly, look, I got love for, I watch so many videos you don't even know. I make videos and I watch videos. I watch hours upon hours of other people's videos, and I got love for people for making those videos. But I feel like I'm filling a hole that I see. And the hole that I see is this. A lot of people that give you graphic card reviews use that graphics card for maybe a day, maybe a week. I've been using the GTX 960 for the whole month of August. I committed to this. I have a 970. I would rather be using my 970 so that I can have more eye candy on my monitor. But I'm doing all of my gaming with a 960 for the whole month of August, and I'm using four different GTX 960s. I'm using 2 gigabyte cards, 4 gigabyte cards, cards with one fan on them, cards with two fans on them, all right? And I'm doing this because when I drop that GTX 960 review, it is gonna be thorough. It is gonna tell you exactly what to expect. Now, the sad thing is that card came out in what, February of this year, and it's August now, so you can argue I'm too late. And that video is probably never gonna get a ton of views. All right. I would be lying if I said I don't care about the views, because I do care about the views. I do care about the likes. I do care about the subscriptions to my channel. I care about those things, and I'd be a liar if I said I didn't. But I am trying to build a brand with you guys. I'm trying to build a relationship with you guys so that you know that if I say a card can handle a game at a certain resolution and a certain frame rate, it can do it. Or if I say it can't, I mean it, all right? When I tell you that, sure, here we are. Here, let me get down from here, because for starters, we're gonna have a higher frame rate when we're up here. Let me get down from here. When I tell you, like, we are getting 50, we're in the 50s, all right? 53 right now, 54, 52. When we are getting in the 50s on the Ultra preset, you have every reason to think in your mind that that's good. And I'm here to tell you that it's okay. It's not good. Okay, look, we're at 49. I feel like the game looked more crisp with the settings that I had earlier. All right? I feel like the game played more smoothly. It played with less stuttering. I feel like the overall experience, and that's why we play the games, is to have an experience. I feel like the overall experience was better with the settings I used earlier. However, it's your life, it's your money, it's your computer, it's your time. I am showing you that, okay, in case you're curious, if you don't have a 960 4 gigabyte card, and if you don't have this game, and you are curious to know, can this card handle the game on Ultra? Yes, it can. Clearly it can. Now we're in the 40s, but the whole time it's playable. I don't think it's as crisp, I don't think it's as smooth, but it's playable. So when I make these videos, this is a work of love. This is a labor of love on my part. This is me loving you. This is me saying, look, you can play this game on Ultra. It can handle it. But at the same time, I'm also saying, but this is what I think performs better. This is what I think looks better. And it takes time to make these videos. Because as long as this video is for you to watch, it's longer for me to make. All right? It took me dozens of hours of using this card and this game together to come to this conclusion before I started the video. And then because this video is longer, I'm actually going to have to convert the file of it to get it to upload to the internet, which is like way inside baseball. You probably don't care about that. Point being, this is a labor of love, all right? Because I love you guys. Love everybody. But I love you guys. So hopefully these videos are helpful to you guys. I know they're long, but they're really thorough, and I really feel like I cover things. And maybe there's some other channel that's already established that does what I'm doing, and I haven't found that channel yet. But you know what? Even if there is, this is still what I want to do. I mean, I still feel compelled to make these videos. I still feel compelled to show you how things perform, and I don't just do video game stuff. Now, my video game stuff has the most views on my channel by far, okay? Even a bad video game, views-wise, even a bad video game video on my channel has more views than a lot of other stuff. Now, I do vacuum cleaners. I do carpet shampooers. I do electric razors. I do all kinds of products, okay? I'm going to be doing cars, Apple products, Samsung products. I've got a Galaxy S6 video up right now. So I have a lot of interests. And when it comes to me doing reviews and me doing demonstrations, I like to be thorough, guys. I like to really share the knowledge with you. So anyway, oh, and the game, it's stuttering right now. It doesn't feel very good. It says it's getting 4850 frames per second, but it's not a smooth 4850 frames per second. It's kind of stuttery. But anyway, thanks for watching, guys. I do appreciate that you watch my videos, and I get comments from you guys, and I get the thumbs up, and I get the subscriptions, and I appreciate the love. I really do. I put a lot of work into these videos, and this is... I spent a lot of time talking at the end of this video. With these benchmarking videos I've been doing for the 960, I haven't done as much talking. So if you watch the other ones, you don't have to worry about there being this much talking, because there's not. But just kind of wanted to share what was on my mind. Just kind of letting you guys know where I'm coming from. So love you guys. Thank you for patronizing my establishment. Thank you very much. This has been AI Gaming 1776, and y'all have an excellent time.